Hello, my dear children. So today I will continue with the lesson. The name of the lesson is Growth of Indian Nationalism. In my last video class, we have been discussed the two factors which were responsible for the growth of Indian nationalism. Today in this video class, we'll discuss the role of socio-religious reform movement. So it's a very important and it has its tremendous contributions that the people of India create a feeling of nationalism. So, see my dear children, the social religious reform movement of the 19th century were great pioneers of Indian nationalism. This social religious reforms movement touched almost every segment of the Indian society. In the spheres of social reforms, it tried to eradicate the evil aspects which was prevalent in the society at that time. For example, caste system, sati, dowry system, pardha system, etc., etc. And in the sphere of religious, it tried to reform the religious superstitions and heredity, priesthood, etc. So, the social religious reform movement fought for the individual liberty and social equality. My dear children, in your textbook, there are some of the organizations which play a great role to create a feeling of nationalism and to uplift the society to transform India into a modern India. Some of the organization has given. Let's start with the Brahmo Samaj. So, my dear children, Brahmo Samaj, as you all know, it was founded by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Raja Ram Mohan Roy was born in an orthodox Brahmin family in Bordowan district, which is in West Bengal. He is the one who is regarded as the father of modern India, also the maker of modern India, because he contributed immensely in eradicating social evils prevalent in the society during the 18th century. So, what happened in the year 1797, the Christian missionary had established a printing press at Srirampur mission. Srirampur is located in West Bengal. They have an objective. Now, what was the objective? The objective was of the propagations of Christianity. In their news magazine, they published by projecting Christianity is a great religion of the world. Also in those magazines, they passed derogatory remarks on Hinduism. Derogatory means disrespectful remarks against Hinduism. Okay. So Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he stood against this. He was the one person who protested this, and to defend, he also published two pamphlets. One is Brahman Sabhadi and another Brahman Missionary Sangbad, where he wrote articles on Hindu religion and its philosophy. He wrote that the corruptions on the Hindu religion were a creation of the later age, mainly the work of Orthodox Brahmin. And in the year 1828, he founded the Brahmo Samaj. See my dear children, Raja Ram Mohan Roy deeply studied and reinterpreted the ancient Hindu scripture. He translated Upanishad and many other Hindu scripture so that the common people could understand the real philosophy of Hinduism. And he also stated that according to the Vedas and Upanishad, God is one, God has no shape. He is omnipotent and omnipresent. Raja Ram Mohan Roy was also against idol worship. So, don't think that he only worked for the religious reform. He was not confined with the religious reformations of Hindu, but also he worked for the social reform. As I have told you, he denounced caste system, child marriage, bardha, polygamy, etc., etc. He motivated the young men of Bengal to marry the widow. Okay, and with the help of Lord William Bentinck, he abolished sati system permanently. Okay, and also Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he founded the famous Hindu College at Calcutta in the year 1817, which later became the famous Presidency College. Raja Ram Mohan Roy also approached the British to bring about liberal reforms in the administration. He was the one person who advised the British administration to separate the judiciary from the executive. So, my dear children, Raja Ram Mohan Roy touched the every corner. Okay, he worked on social, he worked on religious, he also worked for the good he also advised the British administration for a smooth and good administration. Thus, Raja Ram Mohan Roy is regarded as one of the important figure in the history of India, who had an immense contribution to transform India into a modern India. And that is why he is regarded as the father of modern India and a maker of modern India. Now I will go to the next Samaj or organization, which has equally contributed to transform India into a better India. And the name of this Samaj is Arya Samaj. So, first of all, let's see who founded this Arya Samaj. Arya Samaj was founded by a great scholar, Swami Dayanand Saraswati, in the year 1875. Like Brahmo Samaj, the Arya Samaj also criticized child marriage, caste system, etc., and regarded as social ills. Swamiji considered the Vedas as the true source of Hinduism, and he gave a slogan. What was the slogan? Go back to Vedas. This was the slogan. And with that slogan, he attracted many people. Okay. So, this Arya Samaj also worked very hard to uplift the society and to eradicate all those evils which was practiced at that time. Now I will go to another Samaj. The name of that is Parthana Samaj. So Parthana Samaj was started by Keshav Chandra Sen in Maharashtra in the year 1869. With an aim to make people believe in one God and to worship only one God. Like Brahmo Samaj and Arya Samaj, this Samaj also worked very hard to transform the society into better society. Thus, this Samaj established many orphanages for the homeless and night school for the illiterate and unprivileged. So, Parthana Samaj also play a major role to transform India into a better India. Now, the next missions or organization which has also worked very hard, that is, it is called Ramakrishna Mission. So Ramakrishna Mission was established by Swami Vivekananda in the year 1897. It was established to spread the message of Ramakrishna Paramahansa. Now questions come here, who is Ramakrishna Paramahansa? See, my dear children, Ramakrishna Paramahansa was a saint person. He was a very simple and pious person. he was the one who attracted many followers, okay, and only to spread the message of Ramakrishna, Swamiji as started this Ramakrishna mission, also with twofold purpose. The two main twofold purpose are, one is to spread the teaching of Vedanta. See, my dear children, Swami Vivekananda was the one person who took Vedanta to the world. He was the one person who teach Vedanta in a very simple language, and he regarded that Vedanta is the true source of knowledge. And another purpose is to improve the social conditions of the people. For that two-fold purpose, Swamiji started this Ramakrishna mission. Swami Vivekananda wanted to unite the Indians as well as to prove the fact that Indian philosophy and spiritual ideas were the best in the world. So he started this organization, and still we have Ramakrishna mission. You will find in every district they are working. Now going to the next society or next organization which has also give his best to improve the society, this is known as Theosophical Society. By the word Theosophical Society, we can understand that this is not an Indian organization. Yes, my dear children, the Theosophical Society is an international organization. Originally, it was established in New York, and in the year 1885, its branch was opened in Ayodhya in Madras. It was gained popularity in India only for an Irish lady. Her name was Annie Besant. She gave full efforts to recognize and popularize the movement in India. She reminded the Indians about the richness of Indian philosophy, culture and heritage. She was also against conversion because she regarded that Indian has his own rich philosophy. She also started the Central Hindu School in Banaras in the year 1898, which ultimately became Hindu University in 1816. See, my dear children, in the year 1916, she started a movement. The name of the movement was Home Rule League. Home Rule League means self-rule. Okay, she wanted that Indian people should rule by themselves. And she is also the first lady president of the Indian National Congress. In the year 1917, she was selected as the first lady president of Indian National Congress. Now, the last organizations which has given its tremendous contributions for a special community that is known as Aligarh Movement. The Aligarh Movement was started by Sir Syed Ahmed Khan because he was deeply concerned with the depressing conditions of the community during the British Raj. Of the community, it indicates the Muslim community. The main objective was to persuade the Muslim to acquire modern knowledge and English. The Aligarh College, which was later known as the Aligarh University, was also established by Sir Syed Ahmed Khan. The Aligarh College played a very important role to raise the level of political consciousness amongst the Indians. So these are the organizations which they have given their tremendous effort to uplift the society and to transform India into a modern India. So My dear children, in the last part of the 18th century and in the beginning part of the 19th century, the social religious movement has its tremendous contributions towards the society. So I have not gone in lengthy, though it is a video class. One thing, you read the textbook, the concept will be more clear.